Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. Today we are going to do discussion on fertilizer subsidy. This topic is part of your GS3 syllabus that talks about agriculture economy. In these slides, we will discuss in detail what this fertilizer subsidy is, which are the new reforms that have been introduced in it, which are the changes that have been introduced, why these changes have been introduced. We'll discuss in details what is fertilizer, what are the different types of fertilizers that are there. We'll also discuss what are the impacts of fertilizer on the environment. So let's begin. So basically, what is fertilizer? It is a natural or chemical substance that is put on land or soil to make plants grow better. It can also be put on the tissues of plants. It contains essential nutrients which are required by the plants, including nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus. It can also include lead, iron, etc. Right? They enhance the water retention capacity of the soil and it also increases its fertility. Types of fertilizers. There are two types of fertilizer that are there. Some are inorganic fertilizers and some are organic fertilizers. Inorganic are the chemical ones which are made from the chemical beans, right? These are the chemical fertilizers that contain nutrient elements for growth of crops made by chemical means. The inorganic fertilizer types are nitrogen fertilizers. They contain nitrogen necessarily, which is necessary for development of crops. Nitrogen is the main constituent of chlorophyll that maintains the balance of process of photosynthesis. It also part of amino acids in the plants and constitutes protein. Nitrogen fertilizer improves the production and quality of agriculture products. You should also remember that India introduced fertilizer in agriculture in the year 1960s during the Green Revolution to increase the crop yield. Next is phosphorus fertilizer. The main nutrient in a phosphorus fertilizer is phosphorus. The efficiency of the fertilizer depends upon effective phosphorus content, methods of fertilizing, properties of the soil and crop strains. Phosphorus found in the protoplasm of cell plays an important role in the cell growth and proliferation. The phosphorus fertilizer is beneficial for the growth of roots of plants. It is important for the roots of the plants. Right? What are organic fertilizers? Well, they are natural fertilizers. They are obtained from plants and animals. It enriches the soil with carbonic compounds essential for plant growth. Organic fertilizer increases the organic matter content of the soil, promotes the reproduction of microorganisms, and changes the physical and chemical properties of the soil. It is also considered to be main nutrient for green food. So basically, it contains the vegetable and animal wastes. Right, so it can be formed from following products such as agriculture waste, livestock manure, industrial waste, municipal sludge. Right, from all these products we can obtain organic fertilizers. So what is fertilizer subsidy? Do tarah ki fertilizer subsidy hai. One is urea based, other is non-urea. So jo urea fertilizer subsidy hai, it is sold at MRP, which is statutorily fixed by Government of India. Government of India kisi law ke तहत MRP decide karti urea ki. Aur jo difference hai between farm gate, right? Jo farmers ko price dena padta hai aur jo market ka price hai, net market price. Uske beech mein jo difference hai, that is given as subsidy by the government to manufacturer and importers, right? So the difference between the delivered cost of urea at the farm gate and the net market value of urea is given as subsidy to the urea manufacturer and importer by the Government of India, right? The MRP of the non-urea fertilizer are fixed by companies. Jo non-urea fertilizer, unke MRP companies fix karti hain. And the center pays a flat per ton subsidy on these nutrients to ensure that they are priced at reasonable levels. It is called nutrient-based subsidy. Next is urea and non-urea fertilizers. So urea fertilizers, they get more subsidy as compared to non-urea fertilizers. It also contains around 46% of the nitrogen. Also, there are many other uses of urea fertilizers, right, which is resulting into misuse of urea fertilizers, such as it is being subsidized, hence it is misused for non-agriculture purposes, such as for binder, for binding plywood and particle board makers. It is used as cheap protein source by animal feed manufacturers or adulterant by milk vendors. It is also being smuggled to Nepal and Bangladesh. So because of this misuse, government is making changes in this subsidy. How is the subsidy paid and who gets it? जो पहले सिस्टम था उसके तहत जो फर्टिलाइज़र कंपनीज हैं उनको सब्सिडी जाती थी, लेकिन जो अल्टीमेट बेनिफिशियरी होता था वो फार्मर्स होते थे, हु पेज MRP विच इज़ लेस देन दी मार्केट डिटरमाइंड रेट्स. अर्लियर द कंपनीज वर पेड आफ्टर द बैग्ड मटेरियल हैज़ बीन डिस्पैच्ड, बट नाउ न्यू सिस्टम हैज़ बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द ईयर 2018. अ डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर सिस्टम वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड वेयर इन सब्सिडी पेमेंट टू द कंपनीज वुड हैपन ओनली आफ्टर एक्चुअल सेल्स टू फार्मर्स बाय रिटेलर इज डन. जैसे कि आपका फार्मर है, इट गोज टू द रिटेलर्स, राइट, रिटेलर उसको सब्सिडाइज रेट पे फर्टिलाइजर प्रोवाइड करेगा. और ये जो ट्रांजैक्शन है, ये POS सिस्टम जो कि पॉइंट ऑफ सेल मशीन है रिटेलर के पास, उसके थ्रू जो लिंक्ड है ई उर्वरक पोर्टल, उसमें रजिस्टर हो जाएगी. ये डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फर्टिलाइज़र का पोर्टल है, राइट, इसमें जैसे ही लिंक हो जाएगी ये रजिस्टर हो जाएगी ये ट्रांजैक्शन, तो इसके थ्रू जो कंपनीज हैं दे कैन क्लेम सब्सिडी, राइट. सो ईच रिटेलर नाउ हैज अ पॉइंट ऑफ सेल मशीन लिंक टू द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स ई उर्वरक DBT पोर्टल. एनीबडी बाइंग सब्सिडाइज फर्टिलाइजर्स इज रिक्वायर्ड टू फर्निश हिज हर आधार यूनिक आइडेंटिटी और किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड. After the sales get registered on e-urvarak platform, the company can claim subsidy. Steps ahead. तो government को changes लेके आ रही है, जैसे कि it is planning to restrict the number of fertilizers bag that an individual farmer can buy during any cropping season. So presently 100 bags are allowed for even the non-farmers, right? Which is leading to the misusage of this subsidy. So now government is saying कि cropping season के आधार पे बैग्स दिए जाएंगे फर्टिलाइजर्स के. जैसे कि खरीफ में कैपिंग हो गई, 30 बैग्स आर ओनली अलाउड, राइट, रबी में ओनली 20 बैग्स आर अलाउड, सो लाइक दैट. टू कर्ब दिस मिसयूज, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज डिस्कसिंग टू प्लान टू कैप द नंबर ऑफ सब्सिडाइज फर्टिलाइजर्स बैग दैट एनी पर्सन कैन बाय ड्यूरिंग एन एंटायर खरीफ और रबी क्रॉपिंग सीजन. दिस इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू एंड इवन रिटेल लेवल डिवर्जन एंड परचेजेस बाय लार्ज बायर्स इन डिसगाइज ऑफ फार्मर्स. The government should seriously consider paying farmers a flat per acre cash subsidy that they can use to purchase any fertilizer. The amount they could vary depending on the number of crops grown and whether the land is irrigated or not. This may prevent diversion and also encourage judicious application of fertilizers with right nutrient, macro and micro combination based on proper soil testing and crop specific requirements. So there are also environmental damage that has been done due to inappropriate use of fertilizers by many states. Considering that fertilizer subsidy is second biggest subsidy after food subsidy, the inaction on the part of the government is not only worrying the fiscal health of the economy but also detrimental to the soil health of the country. So we need to make sure, जैसे कि soil health card scheme है तो उसका ठीक से usage हो, fertilizers के लिए हम लोग soil based analysis को use करें, right? जिससे कि जुडिशियसली फर्टिलाइजर का यूज़ किया जाए. सिंस फर्टिलाइजर प्राइसेस अलाउ फॉलो द ट्रेंड इन द इंटरनेशनल पेट्रोलियम प्राइसेस, राइट, द ओनली वे टू रिड्यूस द सब्सिडी बिल इज टू रिड्यूस द डिपेंडेंस ऑन इम्पोर्ट्स एंड इंक्रीज डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्शन. वी नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट वी आर सेल्फ रिलायंट इन केस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स. वाइल रैशनलाइजिंग फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी अक्रॉस न्यूट्रिएंट्स मे बी शॉर्ट टर्म एंड इमीडिएट सॉल्यूशन टू द प्रॉब्लम, वी नीड टू रिसेंटली rationalize fertilizer subsidy, right? We need to make sure कि misusage ना हो और rationalize किया जाए fertilizer subsidy को. The need of the hour is to have a policy framework that incentivizes domestic production of fertilizers. The bigger challenge is to change the pattern of fertilizer usage. So your homework is that you have to web search that which of the countries are supplying India fertilizers, from where we are importing fertilizers. I hope this helped you to understand this topic in depth. For more such videos, please like, share and subscribe Abhimanyu channel. Thank you.